So finally, we had to contract someone to do the biodigester and the soak away pit or the soak pit. So of course, a biodigester and a soak pit are both methods for managing waste, but of course they operate differently and they have different purposes. So the biodigester system, as you've said, breaks down organic matter. So the matter can either be food waste, can be animal waste or human waste, through anaerobic digestion. And the anaerobic digestion is it's a biological process where microorganisms break down the organic matter, of course, in the absence of oxygen. So when this process is done, we are going to the biodigester, of course, will, after the process, will have biogas, and this biogas is in form of there's methane and of course carbon dioxide, and also there's a nutrient-rich effluent. So well, it depends with what you want, with what you want to achieve with the with your biodigester, but for us we're just going to use it to manage the waste from the house, from the bathrooms, from the kitchen, from, you know, all that. But of course, the waste from the kitchen is going to go to, it has its own soak away pit, and it's different from the major system of the house. Of course, from the advice that we got, the wastewater from the kitchen and the wastewater from the kitchen is not supposed to go through their biodigester, because, you know, kitchen waste has a lot of grease in them, and it can really make the biodigester be so inefficient. So the kitchen waste is going to have its own. So we have the input, which is basically the organic matter, and then after that, after the input has gone into the biodigester, then anaerobic digestion happens inside the biodigester, whereby microorganisms break down the organic matter in the absence of oxygen, thereby producing biogas, mainly methane and carbon dioxide, and of course a nutrient-rich effluent. So the biogas produced during anaerobic digestion can be collected and be used as a form of renewable energy, if you wish to, depending on the scale of the biodigester system. Then the nutrient-rich effluent that remains after digestion can be used as a form of fertilizer for crops, and this is due to its high content in nitrogen, potassium, and phosphorus. Of course, we also have a soak pit, and we have a soak pit for the main. We have the main soak pit and the soak pit that is going to have the water waste from the kitchen, specifically from the kitchen, because we should not mix them. Simply because the wastewater from the kitchen is normally greasy, and the biodigester does not want anything that is greasy. That is why we have a different soak pit for the kitchen section. So a soak pit or soakaway pit is it's a simple method for disposing wastewater from household activities such as bathing, laundry, or kitchen use. And how this soak pit of course, what the soak pit does is that it allows water to slowly percolate into the surrounding soil, where it is naturally treated and filtered. So soak pits are commonly used in areas where a form of centralized wastewater treatment systems are unavailable or are impractical, because like in this area, everyone is managing their waste individually. So the idea of a soak pit provides somewhat a decentralized and environmentally friendly solution to waste management or waste disposal. So a soak pit works in a sense that wastewater from household activities is directed into the soak pit through, of course, a network of pipes or drains. And then once it is inside the soak pit, the wastewater, that is the wastewater, we are talking about the wastewater. So once the wastewater is inside this, is in the soak pit, It will percolate through the layers of gravel that have been layered in the pit, and this gravel acts as natural filters. So the layers remove pathogens and any contaminants from the wastewater. So as the water percolates downwards downwards, it undergoes biological and physical processes that helps it break down the organic matter and remove pollutants. And eventually, the treated water is absorbed back into the soil. And some of the benefits of having a biodigester is that there's a form of renewable energy production, depending on the scale of your biodigester, because the biogas produced can be used as a form of renewable energy. Of course, there's also through the recycling of the wastewater, we can get a nutrient-rich effluent that can be used as a form of fertilizer for agricultural purposes. And also there is waste reduction, because biodigesters help in the safe and efficient disposal of human waste, thereby reducing the risk of water pollution and public health hazards associated with untreated sewerage. So, of course, you have to consider the design and the capacity. And by capacity, I mean factors that you need to consider is the population size that is going to use the facility. And for us, the population size is not going to be huge. So the kind of biodigester that we've done is just good for the facility. And, of course, you have to really put into consideration how you're going to manage the effluent from the biodigester. So it should be managed properly to prevent any form of contamination. And of course, the biodigester should be maintained properly by, you know, monitoring the operation of the biodigester. And of course, we have already been trained on how we are supposed to use the system to ensure proper waste management practices. Yeah.
Our hearts beat the city streets, we began to feel the fire. We rise like tall buildings as the chemicals they take us higher. The night's young and it's just begun as she puts her hand in mine. We wanna chase the night, wanna dance to the light. Pulls us from the sky, just two hearts running wild. Never sleep, never stop. Every shot from the top, we're gonna be two hearts running wild.